In this video, I'm going to show you how to integrate Stripe into your Base44 app so that you can collect payments from customers. So here I am in an app I've built in Base44. The content of the app doesn't matter so much. It's really just about learning how to set it up with Stripe. So I'm going to use Base44's new setting here, which if I go into app settings, there's backend functionality, which you do need to be on their $50 a month plan right now to have that. It's possible they'll change that in the future, but right now that's what it is. And then the reason we need that is this is going to allow us to add a server-side functionality and add API calls through the backend. So what I'm going to do now is, in the chat, what I'll do is I'll say, let's add Stripe functionality to the app to keep it simple for now. Let's just have a one-time payment with a paywall to access all content. And basically what this app is essentially just a database of podcasts. And so you can think of it just as a directory that we're going to put a paywall on. You could do it as a subscription or a one-time payment. So let's start here in this video with a one-time payment. So to do that, let's go ahead and send that message on Base44. And it should know to do it with the backend function here and the dashboard settings, app settings, backend functions. So what I think it's going to do is set up those API calls with Stripe, should ask me for an API key, and then set everything up. So I can see it's already asking me for API credentials. And while it's doing that, it's going to start explaining what I built. So if I click set secrets, I need a Stripe secret key, Stripe publishable key, and Stripe webhook secret. So to do that, I need to go into my Stripe account. So I'm going to go into Stripe. Here I am on the top left. What you can do is go into sandbox mode. What's nice about sandbox mode is it's going to allow you to test things out really easily. And it's going to give you like secret keys and publishable keys that you can use in test mode before going into live mode. So I'm in the sandbox and then I'm just going to go down. Actually, I could probably just search for API keys. So I'll show you on the top, search for API, go to API keys. So here's publishable and secret key for my test account. So I'm going to paste that in, publishable key, and the secret key. And then on the webhook secret, what we do is we need to create a webhook. So to do that, we're going to search for webhooks, and then we will create an event destination. Now, I don't know if it's going to tell us here what specific event endpoints it needs. So why don't I save those two for now, and then I'll get the webhook secret afterwards. So I've added the Stripe secret. What I'm going to say, let me just pause it and I'll say, explain how to set up the webhook. So let me get a little bit more information because there are different ways to set up the webhook. So here is the URL. So I'm going to copy that. And then that goes here in the webhook as the endpoint URL. And then I can see it wants me to listen for checkout.sessionCompleted, which is the specific endpoint that we want. So we're going to select the event, search for that, and add event. So right now we're not doing a subscription, so we're just going to look for that checkout session completed, add the endpoint, and then what we need to do is reveal the signing secret and then copy it. And then we're going to go back and then add that webhook secret. And then I can also maybe go back and add the ones that I did before as well. Okay, so it says that it has built it all out now. So let's see. We have a paywall. If I click unlock now, hopefully this takes us to a Stripe checkout page. So it looks like it's loading now, which is pretty cool. One thing that I'm going to do is actually test this in another tab, because sometimes I notice with Stripe specifically, there can be issues there. So let me log in. And then here I am at the paywall. I'm going to click unlock now. And yeah, there we go. That's what I was hoping. So sometimes just something to be aware of is when you're testing inside of these app builders, there can be issues. So do it in another tab with Stripe. So for testing, you just do 4242 across the board, any date in the future, any CVC, put in your name, put in a zip code. And then what we want to do is uncheck that and click pay. So hopefully this works. This should send us back. So it successfully worked. It sent us back. Payment successful. And now I can go to the app. And the only issue is it looks like it didn't successfully update my account, although it did see that I successfully paid. So there's an error. You must be logged in to access this app and the webhook. Okay, so if we go back to Base44, what I want to do is say, it almost worked. Only issue was the webhook. So the app didn't know I was subscribed, but I was able to pay. The error in Stripe or the webhook is this. So let's see if Base44 is able to solve this. So this can be tricky. I've done this many times with Stripe, and just getting these webhooks to work can be a little tricky sometimes. And let's see if I resend this webhook. So it looks like I got the same error. I could just try again and see if the same thing happens. Okay, and then let's see. I'll refresh the webhooks. Might have gotten the same error. So I'm going to say, okay. So I think we're getting close, but we are still running into that one error. Okay, so we're going to do it in a slightly different way. Instead of using webhooks, what I'm going to do is just change the user status based on the successful payment, because the app did seem to recognize that the payment was successful. So let's see if this works this time. So let's go back to the app, fresh, and let's try this. So we'll go back to Stripe. This part seemed to work, and let's pay. And then it should throw us back because it knew it was successful. It went back. I did see the success sign on the app, verifying payment. Payment successful. And then let's see if I go to the app. Now I do have access. So that part did seem to work successfully. So we successfully set up Stripe. We were able to do a one-time payment and unlock content on our app based on that one-time payment. Now, the one part that I wasn't able to do in this video is set up the webhooks, which is really crucial for subscriptions, because we need to get webhooks to let us know if someone canceled their subscription, when their subscription renews. There's a lot of information there that's very helpful. That'll be what I'll do in a future video with Base44, is show you how to set up subscriptions with webhooks. So be sure to subscribe to our channel for that. If you have any questions at all, leave a comment below, and I'll see you in the next video.